Hi, and thank you for watching my video. In this video, I will take you along with me to Bali. And this video includes several long meditative shots without much commentary because I think it's very peaceful and nice. And it's something that I enjoy watching myself. It also includes some landing and takeoff footage that some people might think is boring or uninteresting. However, I think also that it's calming and meditative, and I liked to watch videos like this whenever I was trying to get over my fear of flying. So, this is a fear of flying friendly video. Moreover, analytics show that most people don't watch past a minute and 51 seconds of any of my videos anyway. So, it doesn't really matter, does it? I hope you enjoy this video of my trip to Bali. Hey, here I am in LAX International Terminal. It was a short flight here, 54 minutes, and now it's gonna be one of the longest flights in the world from Los Angeles to Singapore, which is gonna be about 18 hours. So for somebody that used to have an extreme fear of flying, an 18-hour flight, I can't say I'm completely over my fear of flying, but it's gonna be okay. So. Here we are at the gate, and here's our caterer's flying food group at Singapore Airlines. Oh, wonderful.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is your ground staff speaking. Singapore Airlines is currently paging for passenger Mr. Isaac Irving. Once again, Mr. Isaac Irving, if you hear your name, please make yourself known to any Singapore Airlines staff.
Hey there, I see you're still watching. Thank you. be signing autographs after the video's over. Now, in this section of the video, I wanted to mention a few things that might help you get over your fear of flying, especially on a long flight. One thing that helps me is finding a comfort movie, and that movie is Forgetting Sarah Marshall. So on the flight to Singapore, I watched Forgetting Sarah Marshall no fewer than 5 times, maybe more. But I also tried to get some sleep. So on today's menu, we have eggplant meatballs, bread, square item, and cheese and crackers, and salad. And I had an excellent meal, and it also helps to watch the flight map. It helps me anyway. I enjoy watching the progress of the flight, and I find it a little bit calming. Hi again. I've changed backgrounds, but don't worry, you're still watching the same video. I just wanted to pop in for a minute and talk about the Singapore airport. As you can see, it's wonderful for tying nature into construction, and there's a very calming feeling in the garden areas, of which there are many. And the Singapore airport is one of the busiest in the world, with over 400,000 flights per year. From Singapore to Bali, we took an economy airline called Scoot, and Scoot provides its own indoor clouds. After so many hours of travel, it was a delight to get to the arrivals hall of the Bali airport. And it was honestly one of the most beautiful arrivals halls that I've ever been to. And it featured a lot of art from the area, including an array of shadow puppets. Now, if you've been on many, many international luxury tours, like I have, you know that after you exit the airport, somebody will be waiting outside holding up a sign with your name on it.
At this airport, I saw the most people holding signs up that I've ever seen anywhere, indicating just what a massive tourist industry the island of Bali has. It was very interesting. During our ride from the airport to our hotel, our guide was explaining to us that people from outside of Bali can't buy property, but they can rent for up to 30 years. And they can open a business, but only if they go 50-50 partnership with a Bali resident. Now, as maybe one or two of you know, Bali is a majority Hindu island in Indonesia. Indonesia is a majority Islamic nation and is made up of over 17,000 islands.
Bali 2.5 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Like from Singapore come to Bali, also 2.5 hours.
Uh-huh, yeah.
This Singapore is here.
Yeah.
So these hanging chairs were super cool, and I'd like to report that I actually sat in one, but I was a little bit paranoid that I would get like off balance or something, and that like my fat buns would fall out of the chair, or that it would like break, even though that's not really possible. But I didn't sit in one of these, but I wish that I had. The surrounding area is so beautiful, and there's an infinity pool down below. There's a couple having a little photo shoot down there, so cute. And there's a river flowing by, it's wonderful. There's the town perched in the mountains, it's so picturesque.
Pendants, spoon, bracelet, and then from silver block before we can do silver wire like this one. This is, we make it small one, and then we put to make it size like this, we pull. And then we fire. Yeah, more like this one. This is more than wire, we need it for decoration. We make it decoration. Glue. Yeah, stick, take it glue, and take it ball, take it wire, one by one, until finish. Yeah, a finish a decoration, but to make it strong one, we solder again. He is making ring like this one. With stone, this is stone, we call it turquoise. This is not from Bali, same from Borneo. Yes. Sometimes it's like this one. Yeah. That one black like that one. First, this is wire.
After visiting the silversmith shop, we got a tour of their house. Now, it might look like a Hindu temple, but that's because every house actually has a Hindu temple. And it was very interesting walking around the housing complex, which usually contains 5 buildings and always does have a temple. The other buildings are for members of the family.
Different colors. The colors represent a different manifestation of God in life. In Hinduism, it is, they believe in one God.
The next part of our tour was a walk through a beautiful park and through a coffee rotisserie. A coffee rotisserie area unlike most, in that this coffee is called Luwak coffee or civet coffee. And if you know about it, you know. But these darling little creatures are fed coffee beans, or they choose to eat them on their own. And the coffee bean shell stays intact through the digestive system of the sweet little creature. And in the end, out the end, comes the coffee beans, and then they are treated as regular coffee beans. They're collected from the animal's poo-poo and then roasted as usual to give us some delicious civet coffee or luwak coffee. And we tried some while we were there, and we brought some back. And I can testify that it is delicious and doesn't taste at all like poo.
The last one, vanilla coffee for relaxing.
Cheers.
Vanilla coffee for antioxidant. Wellness tea for prevent cancer and control cholesterol. Plenty for immune system. This one has chocolate. This one has salad tea for blood circulation. Ginger tea for stomach problem. Thai tea good for bones. The last one, lemon grass tea good for diet.
Okay. Thank you. Rice tea. Have it. But you like it, yeah?
It's good. It's
yeah. So this is the legendary civet coffee, the so-called poop coffee. Which I've wanted to try for well over 10 years. But this is the best price, I think, in the US. This is $80 a cup. Here it's about $3. So probably figured it was worth the, you know, worth the opportunity to give it a shot. So I'm not sure what to expect. Let's see. Okay, it's nice. It's just black, and usually I put lots of cream to take the acidity out. It's pretty low acid. There's still some. Mm. It's nice. It's a nice flavor.
After we drank all of the civet's coffee, we went to a restaurant that had lots of fish outside, and then we went to a monkey forest.
Careful. Gonna stand or sit down? Okay. 1, 2, 3. That's good. 1, 2, 3.
We were warned against making eye contact with the monkeys, letting them take anything from our bag, touching their children,
and giving them any snacks.
So the family own big farms.
Yeah.
Like down there also there's another one. So maybe it's hard to identify the boundary, you know, the sign of ownership. But there's normally from left or the top of their field. For instance, that is a temple, and then from that point to the boundary, it belongs to one. So it's still young rice, it still you know, takes a long time to grow, as you can see. Hi again, and thank you for still watching. You're about halfway through my video. Hi, Mom. And I'd like to take a quick second to thank our sponsor. I actually just wanted to point out this temple that was at our hotel. And Balinese Hinduism is very unique and interesting. There are different traditions, such as the offerings that you see on the ground very often. Some of them you can find in the video here.
We enjoyed a traditional Balinese breakfast by the river. The breakfast included steamed rice with shredded chicken on top, different seasonings, and salad, sort of. Also a snake fruit, which is delicious. It's that little snaky looking ball next to the plate. And if you're still watching and you live in Phoenix and you know where to get snake fruit, please let me know in the comments down below. We started our tour in Ubud, which was a small city inland, and there we found different cultural activities such as visiting temples. But then we transferred to the beach town called Kuta, and as you can see, it's quite different.
Different in that there were a lot of more tourist activities that had to do with the beach and island activities. We were on a boat a couple of times, and my husband actually got to do an underwater walk, which was super cool.
That's my drink for dinner.
Okay.
While my husband was doing his underwater walk, somebody got some great footage of me surfing. Just kidding. After breakfast by the infinity pool, our guide took us to a beautiful seaside temple. Please enjoy the following temple scenes by the ocean without commentary. Thank you. When we got back to our hotel, we were able to catch the sunset at the beach, which was across the street. And then we relaxed in our room and watched Frasier. So this scene was shot in front of a convenience store. The convenience stores in Bali were super cool in that you could go inside and buy your snacks and drinks and then sit outside at the tables in the bar area like as though it were a restaurant. So across the street from this convenience store there was a skate park next to the beach and you can see the people skating with the ocean in the distance and some interesting traffic going by. Oh hey there, just popping in here to wrap up the video for Ginger. You may recognize me from some of her other videos, such as Sacramento Adventures, something something DC, and other various shorts and films about Afghan stuff that so many people care so much about. Anyway, my name is Koala, and I am her service animal, and the rest of the film features the Singapore airport and the jewel,
Now the Jewel is a mall that features an indoor waterfall, and the waterfall has actual rainwater. And we also went to the Pokemon Center, which is the only Pokemon Center outside of Central Asia.
Is that it? Is that the thing? You traveled thousands of miles just for that.
It's even softer than I expected.
And then we went to the Bear Bricks Cafe and spent a nice time. Thank you for watching Ginger's video. We appreciate so much that you've watched to the end, and we look forward to the next time. Please like and subscribe. Comment below if you have any comments. Thank you.